Hey everybody, my name is Justin Judd. I'm here with DyeRite and I'm here to show you how to assemble a set of doubles. To assemble a set of doubles, you'll need your scuba cylinders, a left and right modular valve, an isolation manifold, bolt kits, bands, a tape measure, 2 half-inch wrenches, and lubricant. Before you begin assembly, make sure your cylinders have been visually inspected and are both currently in hydro. First, remove your protective caps and install your valves. Next, you'll want to remove both valve plugs. Make certain the isolator lock nuts are tight against the center of the isolator bar body. Lightly lubricate all exposed O-rings and threads with oxygen-compatible lubricant. Next, lay your tanks on a flat, sturdy work surface parallel to one another. Carefully orient the center isolator bar so that its threads correctly align with those K-valves. The notched lock nut indicating reverse thread direction goes on the left-hand valve. Carefully insert the isolation manifold into both valves at the same time and begin threading the manifold into the valves. Make sure both valves and the isolation manifold are all in correct alignment, as cross-threading can damage or destroy the manifold. If one side begins to thread before the other, back it out and start over. This step may take several attempts and is easier to do with an assistant. Push the bottoms of the tanks closer together to make them parallel again. Continue the step until the tanks are the correct width apart to install the bands. Next, carefully place a band on the tank and scoot it up to where the curved top of the tank meets the flat body. When sliding the bands up, be very careful not to put any unnecessary pressure on the manifold. Hanging the tops of this tank off the edge of the work surface will make this adjustment easier. Next, we're going to put the spacer nut onto the bolt. Not all bolt kits include a spacer nut. If you're concerned about galling, you can put a small amount of silicone lube onto the surface of the bolt at this time. Put the spacer nut on and adjust its position as necessary. Next, put the lock washer into place, followed by the flat washer. Insert the bolt through the bands by starting on the back side of the tanks. Place the flat washer, lock washer, and nut on the bolt, and then snug it down. Do not over-tighten at this point. Place a second set of bands on the bottom of the doubles in the same way the first set were fastened. Use a tape measure to make sure the bolts are spaced 11 inches on center and adjust as necessary. Once the spacing is correct, tighten the nuts until they are snug. Once the bolts on both bands are snug, check the spacing of the bolts has not changed. Turn the manifold until it becomes difficult to spin, then slightly tighten the top and bottom bands until the manifold is easy to turn. Repeat this process until there is approximately 1/8 inch of thread showing on both sides of the isolation bar. At this point, you should position the isolation valve according to your personal preference. Spin the lock nuts tight against the valves, and then tighten with a wrench. Then make sure the bolts on both bands are tight. Take a level or any other flat surface to check the height of the bolt. The top of the bolt should be close to the highest point on the tanks. This height varies according to your personal equipment configuration.
Once you have your bands installed, make sure you install your wing and backplate to ensure proper spacing and depth of the bolts.
Place the front nut on the bolt, then the back.
Once your nuts are installed, fill your tanks, and you're ready to dive. If you like that video, don't forget to smash that like button and hit subscribe for more great content from your Dive Right team.